This is what they were accustomed to, but this is what they have to get used to now. The poor, poor bankers at Crédit Agricole. Noémie is joining us from Paris to tell us what has happened.
Good morning. Investment bankers at Crédit Agricole received last month a note informing them that from now on, their expenses would be capped. The email, included in the email, there were details of the spending caps on hotels and restaurants, as well as the restrictions on taxis in London, Paris, and New York.
David is here with me in London. David, Crédit Agricole is not the first bank to start clamping down on expenses.
No, this has become a pattern in the banking industry recently. Banks that are finding it harder to make money are trying to control their expenses. And one way they're doing that is telling bankers who are accustomed to very expensive expense account meals and hotels and taxis, you need to stop. So back during the financial crisis, we had Citigroup telling its employees to stop doing things like make color photocopies. We had Morgan Stanley more recently keeping a tight leash on their bankers' BlackBerry bills. And yeah, so this is a bit of a pattern. Crédit Agricole is probably the most colorful example we've seen, just putting strict limits on even where their employees can eat.
Well, let's ask Noémie. Noémie, are these limits really that harsh? I gather they can still spend, if they're on their own, up to 25 euros on a meal.
Well, they're not terribly harsh, but definitely, I mean, the standards, I mean, are going to change for the bankers who have always been a bit of the elite, and the investment bankers have always been a bit of the elite within the bank. And if you go and say to Paris and your cap is 165 euros, I mean, that will definitely not get you into the Marriott or the Shangri-La or the Hotel Crayon. A Holiday Inn or a Novotel or Ibis would be more in your price range, and that's definitely a change for investment bankers, and a change they don't like.
So do you think this is another sign that Crédit Agricole is pulling back from investment banking in general?
Yeah, this is definitely the latest sign we've seen of second-tier subpar European investment banks deciding that it just does not make sense for them to compete in this business. And it's really interesting, though, because you know, these guys are people who consider themselves to be masters of the universe and really high-flying rainmakers. And the concept of them holing up in a Holiday Inn Express is really against everything they stand for. And it's probably more realistic in this day and age, but it's not going to go over well.
But it is interesting because during recent scandals, investigations into recent banking scandals, we really have shone a light on the high living culture that a lot of these bankers have.
Yeah, bottles of expensive champagne, going to fancy strip clubs, and going out buying entire steak lunches for trading desks just on a whim. And this is, you know, I think this is part of a broader effort by the banking industry to adapt to a leaner time and put the kind of the pre-crisis days behind them. The funny thing, though, is that this is 2013. The crisis started more than 5 years ago, and just now we're seeing banks doing kind of what seems like routine belt tightening.
And Noémie, I mean, what are the bankers themselves? How are they reacting?
Well, the bankers are very upset. I mean, their status is changing within the bank, and obviously that's something they don't like. And one of the perks of being an investment banker is all this is the fact that you really have no limits on your expenses, and so for them that's really disappointing.
Noémie, David, both, thank you very much indeed.